We aim at making clinical proteomics 100 times more robust and 10 times faster. However, to get a better understanding of the potentials and perspectives of clinical proteomics and how it will influence clinical diagnostics and personalized treatment in the future, we will ask pioneers who are dedicated to making a difference for their 2-minute personal view. Hello, Nikolaj from Evercept. Today, I'm here at the Max Planck Institute in Martinsried to talk to Professor Mathias Mann about clinical proteomics. So, Mathias, let me start by asking you, what is the clinical value of proteomics?
Well, so far it hasn't been very big yet, but we think there's a big value. So in clinical practice, we usually measure proteins. I mean, that's what's happening now. And the promise will be that we measure them all at once and hopefully very cheaply and robustly.
So what, how, where do you see the limitations? What is the major limitations that we need to fix?
Well, right now there are a lot of limitations, but the biggest one is that we cannot get the data in a robust and sensitive fashion right now. So, for instance, we are interested in plasma proteomics and the depth that you can get in a reasonable time. That's pretty low. So we need to work on getting the plasma proteome much deeper and faster and more robustly.
So once we have all these, I mean, basically the workflow fixed,
Yeah.
do you reckon that the clinicians and the MDs are ready to actually adopt this technology? Or are there any other, major limitations that needs to be overcome?
Yeah, for sure it's not going to be easy at that point either. So we need a major rethink, and people don't know, so the clinicians don't know what should they use the levels of hundreds of proteins for. So a lot of new conceptual thinking is also needed. So how and we always have to think about providing clinical value with these measurements. So we have to, in the end, come to some support of clinical decisions. What should happen with these patients, and what do these protein patterns mean for treating this patient?
Where do you see clinical proteomics in 10 years? Is it going to play a major role in precision medicine and also diagnostics?
Yeah, so 10 years is of course a long time, but I definitely hope that it will be part of the picture. I hope that people will routinely get their plasma proteome measured, and then it will be one part of many of wearable technologies, big data, the genomic information. But I think it will be a very crucial part, because we can already see that the information of the levels of a lot of proteins in plasma, for instance, they carry a lot of information of how people can not only be treated but also be kept on an even keel, so they don't come close to the clinic in the first place, which would be our hope.
Super exciting and also a great potential. So hopefully we will get there. At least there's a lot of super motivated people working in this direction. So yeah, let's see how it goes. And Matthias, thank you very much for your input. It
Well,
was
thank you.
great. And stay tuned. We will follow up with other people and try to hunt down the something important.